Hello there. Welcome to part 10 of this tutorial. Today, I'm going to be adding a boss to our game. I'll also be going over how to create more complex AI and building on our spawn system. Hope you enjoy. The process for making our boss will be pretty similar to how we made our enemies. You know what that means? More redundant information. Let's start by creating a new scene. Click on Other Node and add a kinematic body. This will be our boss. Now we can add a sprite. I'm going to use another ship from Kenny's asset pack. Now I want to rotate this and scale it up to be about twice the size of our player. Now we'll need to add a collision shape. I want this to be a rectangle. Remember that this will have to cover the whole sprite. Now we can add two position nodes. These will control where our bullets spawn. I'll rename these spawn position. Remember to differentiate between each node. I'll want to move these toward the end of each gun. Now I want to add a timer node. This will control how fast our boss will be able to shoot. Remember that we're going to set all of this up later. For now I'll select auto start. Finally, we can add an area 2D node and a collision shape. I'm going to rename this detection. Now we can add our shape, which will be the detection area for our boss. For some reason I thought it was a good idea to make these detection areas a circle. Although it works, it might lead to weird enemy movement. Just remember to use the collision shape that works well for your game. Alright, now we have a boss. Before we start coding, I want to make a separate scene for our boss bullets. First add an area 2D node. Now we can add a sprite, collision shape, and timer. Let's add our bullet sprite. I'll use the same one we used for our enemies. I want this to be a bit bigger and to be facing left. Now we can add a rectangle shape. Again, this will need to fit around the whole sprite. Now we can set up our timer. This will despawn our bullets after a certain amount of time. Remember to select auto start. I want our wait time to be about 10 seconds before the bullets are despawned. This will be our boss bullet. Now we can add a script to the scene. This is where we'll code the bullets. The process for this is identical to our enemy bullets, so I'll make this quick. I'll start by creating a speed variable. Now in our physics process function, we can give our bullets some velocity. Now let's connect a body entered signal to our script. This is where we'll set up our collision. Basically, if our bullets are in the player hit method, our player will be hit and our bullets will be destroyed. Now we can connect a timeout signal to our script. When this timer times out, our bullets will be despawned. Alright, now we can start coding our boss. Although this is similar to our enemy, it may get a bit complicated. I'm going to start by creating all the variables we'll need. First, let's preload our boss bullet scene. Remember to use the tscn file. Now we can add a can shoot boolean, which will determine if our enemy can shoot. This will be false by default. Now let's make a variable to represent the player, which will be null. Next we can make a speed and health variable. Remember that you can change this depending on how difficult you want your boss to be. Now we can set up the variables that will control the movement of our enemy. First I'll make a travel boolean, which will be false. Now we'll make a start position variable, which will be 0, and a distance variable. This will determine how far our enemy will travel. Finally, we can connect our spawn position nodes using an onReady variable. Now I want to connect our detection node using a body entered signal. In here, if the player group intersects with the detection area, they will be detected. Remember that we set up groups in the third part of this series. Next we can add a physics process function. This is where we'll set our parameters for movement and shooting. First I'll make a movement variable. This will move our enemy at a constant speed left. Now, if the player is detected, the enemy will stop moving. Then, we'll want to call our travel method, which we'll set up later. The last thing we'll want to do for now is allow our enemy to be collided with using our move and collide method. Now let's add a ready function. We'll want to have our start position to be on the y-axis. Now we can begin setting up our movement. Let's create a travel function. In our first if statement, if our y position is less than our combined start position and distance, we'll set travel to false. However, if it is less than our start position and distance, travel will be true. Then, if travel is true, we'll call our up method. Otherwise, we'll call our down method. In our up method, we'll want the enemy's y position to go up by 2 units each frame, and likewise for our down method. Basically, what we're doing here is, when the boss detects the player and the y position is greater than start position and distance, they will not travel. The opposite is true for the second if statement. Then, if they can travel, they will move 2 units up. If their y position exceeds the start position and distance, they will move down. Does that make sense? Too bad, let's move on. Let's connect a timeout signal to the script from our shoot speed timer. In here we'll set can shoot to true when the timer is called. Now, in our physics process function, when the player is recognized, we'll call our shoot method. This is where we're going to code enemy shooting. Now in our shoot function, if the enemy can shoot, we'll instance our bullet. Remember to create a variable for the bullet. Now we'll set the bullet spawn position equal to our position node location. Finally, we can add the bullet to the scene. We'll also want to start the shoot speed timer and set can shoot to false. Remember that, because there are two spawn positions, we'll want to copy and paste this code so both guns will fire. Remember to differentiate between the different position nodes. I'll just add a 2 at the end of these. The last thing we'll do is set up our damage. In our enemy hit function, when our enemy is hit, we'll have our health go down by 1. Then, if health is equal to 0, we'll have our score increase. Because this is a boss, I'll have it go up by 100. Finally, we'll destroy the boss by calling Q-free. Nice. Now our boss code is set up. I know that was a lot. If you have any questions, feel free to comment. Now we can start coding our boss spawning. First let's add a timer. This will control when our boss will spawn. Remember to select auto start. For the sake of the video, I'm going to have our boss spawn after 10 seconds. Now let's add a timeout node to our main script. First I'm going to preload our boss. Remember to use the tscn file. Now in our boss timeout, I'm going to stop our spawn timer so that enemies stop spawning. Now, let's add a variable that instances our boss. Now we can set our spawn position, which in my case will be 1100 on the x and 320 on the y axis. Next we can add our boss to the scene. Finally, I'm going to stop this timer as well. Nice. Now our enemies stop spawning after 10 seconds. Then, when our boss detects the player, they will move and shoot. I think this works pretty well. Thanks for watching. Although there's more I'd like to add, like enemy variants, power-ups, leaderboards, etc., I think this is a pretty good base for a shmup game. I hope you could find this useful. I'm looking forward to making some cool projects in Godot 4. Stay tuned if you're interested. Have a good day, see you in the next video.